So you have to open all four.
Okay.
Oh yeah, yeah, it's very sensitive.
Ah, very sensitive, yes.
Yeah. Huh? There you go.
The setter will not work if the sensor will be out of range, yes? Hmm?
After that, we need to go into menu and calibrate the zero. Mm-hmm. It's actually calibrated to zero, yes?
Okay.
But if... let's say... I can only show you. Let's say that at this place would be zero. I could say the setter that here is the zero.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes.
Yes.
Uh huh. It's very important
to keep it clean,
to clean it before we calibrate it.
Yeah, that's true. There's all kind of sap that comes from the blades, you know, which probably
yes.
sticks
mm-hmm.
easily there. It's a good point.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now we have the zero.
These figures, are these millimeters or it's just a number, index number, or is that hundreds of millimeters?
Uh-huh.
Not that it would matter, but
they are rather a digital.
Well, these are imperial meters anyway, so it's
imperial,
it's
but
some
mm-hmm, imperial, but there are not correct, you know.
Yeah, just
because there's a digital numbers.
Yeah,
from
yeah.
The,
okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Doesn't necessarily mean anything.
Okay, so it's very important to keep the
clean.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Okay.
Okay. That's all from
mm-hmm.
menu. I will show you now how to just blow the air. Mm-hmm.
So it actually removes the sawdust away
yes.
from there.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Now the plate is supported on these pins inside.
You can have a look.
Yep,
hmm?
Yep, correct.
And
oh, that's a handy
with
system.
This knob.
Yes,
yeah.
Excellent.
Hmm?
Excellent. That's easy. Mm-hmm. The manual system is so slow.
And now. How the thief should be about in the middle of the setting pin.
Yeah, yeah.
It can be a little bit this way. Huh?
On the side.
Yes.
Okay,
Not from this side. Yeah, yeah, because correct. Then yeah. the teeth can be twisted. Missing.
Yes.
In the middle or a little bit
on the right side. Okay.
And
yep.
What should be the high? Maybe I will show you how to look the pin. If we look from this side, the pin looks. Oh. The pin have some flat edge. Yes.
Yeah.
So we should set the teeth just under this point, about
the tip of the. Uh-huh. I see.
So it's you know about in the middle of this sensor.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I can clap it manually. This is correct height. Or in fact, if you turn the blade, you needn't to regulate the hardness because it's the same high, it's the same blade.
Yes.
Okay. To move the arm to the other side. Proper length. About in the middle.
Correct.
Yes. Clamp it. Okay.
Yeah.
We can start.
What were the teeth numbers? Can you write the teeth numbers for the TVS and I can't remember. I'm sure they are in the manual, but just normal.
180 normal blade.
Okay.
So.
You've got 1/3 of that, or
three. It equals 60. Yes.
Okay.
We can set 61.
Okay. Good.
So, ile ma zębów ta długa piła? Okay, I will cut it. I know that this is the length. Spacing we have in millimeters. Spacing we have 22 millimeters.
Okay. This looks all quite clear.
What is the most advantage of this? It's very precious, you know. Every tip is measured, and the setter not leave the tip until it will be in the range.
Yeah.
No.
And it's so much faster than when you
and
idle.
There is the one sensor for one side and the second side, so the one side and the second side are always the same, which is very important.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes?
True, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Any fault things that you may think of, you know, other than blowing the fuse?
Need to rather check the fuse from time to time. Won't work.
Okay.
There's one more thing I can show you. Inside there is the PLC.
I have
one upstairs, so I will take one and show you.
All right.
If something is wrong, you can't go and into menu. It means that this one is hanging like a computer.
Yeah, you have to reboot it.
Yes, okay. Exactly. Here is the, at the back side, there's a little switch.
Yeah.
If you have the power on to the PLC, you need to push this toggle switch to stop position. Wait a few seconds, let the program stop. Then move to the run position.
Okay.
The program will run.
So taking the power off is not enough. You have to do it from here.
Yes. Yeah. And
and it's under this box here, or
yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Unscrew this, and here is the.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But and sometimes mostly it happens during the transport. Mm-hmm. You know, if there is shaking, there is sometimes the back connection between
back
the car.
Connection.
And
So
you need to unconnect and connect one more time the car. Yes.
The rebooting is when the power is on. All right. Okay. Good. All right.
What's more about?
Looks rather straightforward. Otherwise.
You know, it's rather very reliable because you know we use it only on our ReSharp for many years. So. Mm-hmm.